Salutations. I'm Jessico, and you're watching Game Dev Made Easy. I have noticed that many people are interested in learning about the job system and entity component system in Unity, but are having issues with understanding the use of them, what they actually are, and how to implement them. So, why don't I answer some of those questions you may have about them? First things first. The job system and entity component system are two different subjects, but they tend to be explained together because they work very well in tandem. To simplify, let's separate them and cover the subjects one at a time. By episode 5, we will utilize the job system and the entity component system together. The job system is Unity's implementation of multi-threading, and Unity has written the job system from the ground up to interact very well with the core engine. Multi-threading is splitting code to be processed by different processors at various stages of execution. To boil it down further, it allows your code to take advantage of multi-core CPUs. Because of this, you can obtain high performance benefits that extends to significant gains in frame rate. The job system has three very distinct interfaces that you can inherit from: iJob, iParallel4, and iJobParallel4Transform. iJob is for scheduling single jobs that run in parallel to other jobs and the main thread. The execute method does not need any parameters for this version. iJobParallel4 allows you to perform the same independent operation for each element of a native container or for a fixed number of iterations. Requires the execute method to have a parameter of type int and number of iterations. iJobParallel4Transform is the same thing as iParallel4. It allows for you to schedule jobs related to transforms, though. The execute method is unique to the job system and is the method that is called when the job is scheduled to run. There are two main attributes that you can use: read-only and write-only. Read-only allows for multiple jobs to read the data in parallel, meaning that the job doesn't have to be complete before another job can read the data it contains. Write-only allows for multiple jobs to write the data in parallel. In other words, the jobs don't have to be complete before another job has the ability to write to that data. The job system also has its own type that are used over what you are used to. It has what is called a native container, and there are 5 types that reside within the native container that you can use. Native array, which is a fixed-sized array. Native list, which is a resizable native array. Native hash map, which is a key value pair. Native multi hash map, which allows for multiple values per key in a key value pair. Native queue, which is a first in, first out queue system. You can think of each of these as the standard C# versions to simplify it. So a native array is just an array list. A native list is just a list. Native hash map is a hash map. A native multi-hash map is just a hash map that has been extended to have more than one value per key. And native queue is a queue. Each of these take a generic type parameter, which means you can use a mono behavior class as a type for it, vector values, and, well, you get the idea. When creating a native container, it needs to have a type of memory allocation you need for it specified. This allows for you to tailor the allocation for the best performance that suits the use case scenario. There are 3 allocator types for native container memory allocation and release. Allocator.temp has the fastest allocation and is for allocations with a lifespan of 1 frame or fewer. Note: you should not pass native container allocations using temps to jobs. Allocator.tempjob is a slower allocation than temp, but faster than persistent. This one is used for allocations within a lifespan of 4 frames and is thread safe. Note, most small jobs use this type of native container allocation. Allocator.persistent is the slowest allocation but can last as long as you need it to, which includes throughout the application's lifetime. Note, persistent should not be used in performance-critical operations. Fun fact, allocator.persistent happens to be a wrapper for a direct malloc call in C. All allocators must be closed by using a dispose call manually. The anatomy of a job is as followed. You first create a job by creating a struct that inherits from iJob or iJob Parallel 4. The reason for the struct and not a class is due to the job system requires a non-nullable value type to be used. It should also be noted that a job has no native concept of a frame. Define your public variables with any attributes you want for it. Inside of the public void execute method, call any methods you have defined that needs to be directly called. In a mono behavior class, make sure to instantiate a new instance of your job that you created. Allocate, schedule, complete, and dispose of your job in a method that is called by the update method. Now, the job system is useful in many situations. You can generate and process point clouds, check for arrays intersecting with bounds, accelerate a very large number of objects at the same time, change the vertices of a mesh every frame, change the vertices and normal of a mesh every frame, and other types of algorithms. Obviously, you can do more than just algorithms with the job system, but algorithms tend to be the most performance intensive and general cause of slowdowns in games. The same goes for graphics processing, and you can use the job system to handle that as well. There is one gotcha that you need to take into account for any time you deal with multi-threading. You must account for the number of threads you have active at any given time and how fast the threads can be processed. You must also take into consideration the user's device and how many threads they have at their disposal to avoid performance hits. Let's look at a few examples of processors and their thread counts. Ryzen 3 1200 has 4 cores and 4 threads. Ryzen 5 1600 has 6 cores and 12 threads. Ryzen 7 2700 has 8 cores and 16 threads. Intel i3 8100 has 4 cores and 4 threads. Intel i5 8400 has 6 cores and 6 threads. Intel i7 7700K has 4 cores and 8 threads. Intel i9 7900X has 10 cores and 20 threads. It should also be noted that this does not take the GPU into account as they already run in parallel and require a different philosophy when working with rendering and computation with them. With that being said, you should now know what the job system is, how it works, and how to use it, in theory. The next video will cover implementing the job system.